Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel and to a new Sierra chart trading guides and tips tutorial where I go over different functions on Sierra chart, specifically geared towards newer users or people that might be used to something like TradingView, where I give you all my tips on how to make the best out of Sierra and start learning the platform, which is what I personally use for all my futures trading. So to begin with, we're going to talk today about how you can mark a anchored VWAP tool. This is something that is not, there's no specific indicator on Sierra to be able to do that or a tool. So I'm going to show you the sort of shortcut or hack that you can use with a volume profile indicator in order to make your own custom anchored VWAPs. So first of all, let's start off here in TradingView, just to show you quickly, because some platforms, including TradingView, have an option over here on the tool menu bars. You can see there's an option called Anchored VWAP. So when you click on it, if I go to this 1 hour SP500 e-mini chart, let's say I want to make a VWAP from this top here on April 18th, I click, and you can see this tool generates automatically a VWAP that's anchored from the point where I click, and is going to just keep extending all the way to the right of the chart following price as it develops. As you know, I have videos on VWAP that I'm not going to go in depth to explain what VWAP is in this video, but it's volume weighted average price, and is basically like a moving average, but it's taken into consideration time, price, and volumes. So for me, it is a lot more useful than moving averages because it takes into account trading volumes, especially useful in the futures market. And so it's one of my most important tools. I mostly use VWAP during my intraday trading. So I have a VWAP that starts at the beginning of each session, but an anchored VWAP is a great tool for swing trading or longer term trading. And so this is a good tool to have, you know, for your higher time frames. So let's go now into Sierra chart and I'll show you how you can make this same VWAP but in Sierra chart. So we have the same chart right here, e-mini S&P 500 1 hour chart. And as you can see, we want to start a VWAP from here, anchored into this high and extending all the way to the end. So I'm going to mark it here. The way we're going to do this is by applying a volume profile from here to the end, and then we're just going to hide the profile and we're only going to leave the VWAP on. Okay, so for this, there's a couple of ways to do it. If you have the advanced package, so if you have package 5 or 11, you're going to have access to the volume profile tool, which is right here under tools. It's called draw volume profile. So if you click this and then you just go on your chart, I'm just going to click on this high and I'm going to drag it forward and then click off again. And now I have a volume profile that's going from here all the way to the end of the chart. Okay. But as you can see, well, this is how I have my default custom volume profile. If you're using this, it's probably going to look different on your platform. The reason mine looks like this is because if we go into the settings, if we go into analysis studies, you can see right here, I have volume profile right here. If I go into settings, I have it saved with a specific color palette. I have hidden the value area lines and the point of control, etc. And I hit set as save as default, and that's why every time I put a balling profile tool, it comes up this way. But just pointing that out because yours might look different. But anyways, for this video, all we care about is the VWAP. As you can see, VWAP is not coming automatically here because I don't have it on. So what we have to do is go to subgraphs, and down here where it says volume weighted average price, you see that mine says hidden. So what I'm going to do is go here, go up and put line. It's a solid line and I have a width of 2. I click apply and you can see that now we have our volume profile, our VWAP here going with our volume profile. And if I go back to trading view, you can see it's pretty much identical. It's the same thing because we're using again the same data. Since futures is a centralized market, it's all the same CME data. And what I have to do now is I need to get rid of this volume profile because, again, all I want to do is have an anchored VWAP. So what I'm going to do is I go again to analysis, studies. Let me move this down here. I go to volume profile. I click settings. First thing I'm going to do under subgraphs is, under settings and inputs, under the short name, I'm going to erase this and I'm going to put anchored VWAP. That way I know when I have my whole list of indicators on this chart, I easily know that this is the anchored VWAP here. Okay. And so over here, what I need to do now, subgraphs, I have this marked again, VWAP as a line, solid, width of 2. You can change the color. You can change the type of line you use, the width, etc. And then under settings and inputs, under the first option that it says draw mode, if I click on it and I go to this pull down menu, you can see there's 3 options. I have the last option enabled, which is volume profile plus point of control, value area, VWAP line, etc. In this case, I'm going to select the second. So basically the second one, it's only taken into account point of control, value area, high, low, and VWAP only with no profile. Then if I go down, you got to make sure that you have, you are not enabling the point of control or value area lines. So for this, under here, extend value area, you're going to select none. Highlight point of control, no. Highlight value area, no. And extend point of control, none. So take all these things off and then just click apply. And now you can see how, since we took off here volume profiles, you can see we had this option before, volume profile plus all the value areas, VWAP and point of control. If I click on draw mode, only these lines apply. Now you can see if I get out, I have my VWAP hinged here and my profile just disappeared. Okay, so that's pretty much how you use a hinged or an anchor VWAP. And then here, I could even click on the edge and then you can see how you get this highlight for the range of your point of your profile. And I can click on the bottom corner and I can just drag this and you can see how I can just move this anchor VWAP to whatever point I want. For example, here, just click and now I anchored it over into this new point right here. Okay. And also, if you want to make sure that this anchor VWAP keeps moving all the way into the future, just go quickly to studies, settings, And you can see here the volume graph period type we have selected from a start date time, which is basically where we anchor it, to an end date time. So over here on the end date, if we want this to keep going into the future, we can just go here and I don't know, I can put 529. So I know that it keeps extending for another month, and I click OK. And now this chart, as price opens next week and continues going on, this VWAP is going to keep following price up until the whatever end time you have, and is going to stay anchored to the point that we selected. Okay, so that's pretty much how you make a custom anchored VWAP on Sierra chart. Hope this video has been helpful. Thank you for tuning in. Remember, as always, to hit that subscribe button, hit the thumbs up. We're almost at 10,000 followers. Probably we might have passed that by the time you watch this video in the future, but let's keep this channel growing to bring you more content like this. If you have any requests for future things you want me to cover in Sierra chart functionality, let me know. Take care, and I'll see you next time.